The Bareminerals Original Foundation, if you haven't been introduced to it yet, is really globally recognised and was a groundbreaking foundation. The reason for that being is that it's made of natural mineral pigments. Now, those natural mineral pigments, for me, sort of combine my skincare qualified expertise with my trained artistry expertise, because my skincare side loves these ingredients for sensitive skin, irritated skin, high colour, if you have breakouts and blemishes. For me, it's almost like a healthy makeup that you can put on. But then my makeup side of me loves the performance of it, because it actually blends with the natural oils of the skin when you buff it on, and it can go from a very light coverage up to a full coverage. Now, a couple of little tricks of how to use it and how to get the best value for money. Do your normal skincare regime. If you use very rich moisturizers, so you maybe got a very dry skin, just wait a few moments for your moisturizers to sink in. If you've got a very oily skin, then you might want to put a mattifier onto your skin first. If you need to, you can use a primer, but it's not always necessary to make this product work for you at home. And then what you do is you buff it on with a brush, and you buff it on out of the lid. So you just take a few, sort of a tiny amount of the powder, and then use a brush, and the brush acts for me like a fountain pen. Now, if you haven't got a brush at home, let me give you some clues of the different types of brushes that'll give you different results. Yes, we've got brushes from Bareminerals, but it could be that you've already got some brushes at home. If you use a fine flat brush, then you can actually use that to get fuller coverage and smooth it onto maybe breakouts, blemishes. You can use it as an eyeshadow base. It's brilliant as an eyeshadow base, by the way. And sometimes even just for natural makeup, just to clean up the look of the lid, if you've got any discoloration there on a darker skin, or if you've got any redness there on a paler skin. If you use a bigger brush, a big fluffy brush, like a sort of blusher brush or a powder face blush, then that's when you'll get that buffing action and apply it in circular movements over the skin. Now, the easiest way to put it on is when you load your brush up, to actually start buffing from the outsides of the face first. So actually apply the foundation on the outside perimeter of the face. Think of the face like a circle, apply it on the circumference, and then buff it in, keep buffing it in to the insides of the face. That's because you're going to load the foundation first on the outsides, where you're not going to see mistakes, and then it's going to flow through the brush, and then you're going to get a more perfected look in the center of the face. And if you do need to get different effects, so you want to use it as a foundation, you want to use it as a concealer, you can just change your brush size too. Definitely always going to be a first purchase for me if you do have either very sensitive skin, very allergic skin. I'll always go back to this foundation time and time again for decades now when I have an allergic or sensitivity breakout. Always a first choice for me. And then also it'd be a first choice for me with you if you have breakout and blemish skin, because with this, for me, you're getting a healthy finish to your makeup. It's complementing your skincare and your problem solving effects that you need on your skin without having a very large complex list of ingredients that could confuse your skin. Finish wise, it gives a sort of natural glow. It's not completely flat and matte, so it does give almost like a natural dewiness. So don't worry, it isn't a powdery finish whatsoever. And common mistakes, let me help you with that. Common mistakes are that you don't buff it in enough. You cannot over buff this product, and buffing is when you use the brush to buff it on more. And one of my top tips with this product as well, even if you love liquid foundations and liquid concealers, if you want really long wear makeup, maybe for wedding or special occasions or fantastic, really, really full fashion coverage, what you can do is put a liquid or creams underneath and use this as a second layer foundation that will give you ultimate performance and long lasting. And that's one of the tricks that we'll do for full coverage or for shoots and shows that you can do yourself at home.